compensation to customers based on that. And they have to pay for expenses for additional services like credit cards, credit cards, etc. And they have a higher cyber insurance premium than the customer stressed off grounds and compensation. So the recommendation is like they need to implement an automated service patch or certificate updating of the network devices. And accurate notification should be sent to the correct departments. Like when that happens, they have to send the correct department. And if the database still is not having any restrictions on the queries that could be run, so they need to keep a restriction on the queries that could be run in the database. And the secure segmentation of servers should be run. And the data governance policy, it was not done properly, so you need to properly implement that. And they should conduct a regular audit on the processes and devices, and it should be precise. And whenever some security incident happens, they should properly inform the government agencies or the clients or customers about it. And they should need a well-designed business continuity plan.
Thank you. 6 minutes and 7 seconds. Managed to finish it a lot earlier. This was supposed to go on for at least 18 minutes. Okay, questions please. Group number 5. Group 5, any questions?
No.
No questions? Good friends?
What is the impact of
that's
hiring?
That's the same. Later. Alex, you have any questions?
How they get in?
How does they get in? Actually, there was Apache Struts vulnerability in the Equifax dispute portal. So they utilized that vulnerability to get access to the initial dispute server. But in the dispute server, there was login details to other database servers also. So from there, they got access to the whole network containing 51 databases.
What was the vulnerability?
Apache Struts vulnerability. Apache Struts is something like a Java framework used for.
Question is, what was the vulnerability in the Apache Struts?
Lack of patch updation.
No, that's simple. That's what happens when there is a vulnerability. What was the vulnerability? It's mentioned in the case study.
It's a web component failure that Apache. So they can directly you use the hyperlink. In order to get into this particular website. So that was what
it's equivalent to SQL injection, but on a URL. So it's mentioned in the case study. So be that case study, it's described you exactly what that is. I think page number 17 or something. Right? Yeah, any other question? Yeah, your question.
How the high cyber insurance is impacting this incident?
Because once vulnerability happens to a particular company, when they next time they want to renew their insurance, because any company will take insurance in order to have a backup. Because when bad allos happens, they have to provide the particular fine to courts and other people. So they will take the insurance, right? So once a vulnerability or anything happened to that particular company, this insurance company will ask to pay more premium. So they will have to pay additional amount of premium for the next level, for the next year, for renewing their premium. Insurance premium, they have to renew every year, right? So that will impact the budget of the company.
Does that answer your question?
No,
sorry. Can you state the question to them again?
My question was how you can say that the higher insurance policy is impacting this type
not,
of incident?
Not higher insurance policy.
As you mentioned in your slide, it should be a higher cyber insurance.
Yeah,
that impact.
Can you show
the
slide, please?
It should be the additional point here.
That is like high cyber insurance premium they have to pay. If they are paying 10 million this time, they have to pay additional 12 million because of this incident. Because the insurance company knows that they are having vulnerabilities in their system. So they will ask for more premium. They have to pay. Not it is related to breach, it is the impact on the company because of this breach happened. Due to this breach happened, this is the financial loss.
Yeah. Yeah, that's why.
Restriction in the sense, because in the database servers, they have in within 76 days, they have run 9,000 queries. Because it is not a good thing, because they have to have at least some definite, because there is no requirement of running every day such huge queries. At least they should monitor that. So why this much queries are happening in the database? They can check in the access log.
We are just asking what is the type of restriction policy has to be set.
Which one? Database segmentation. What is type?
Firstly, which was the act under which they have to give 700 million to some people?
Since it's not, actually FTC has authority over any agencies that collect personal credit information, federal credit company. So FTC, by FTC, there is a rule that if there is any problems caused for the information they have collected by these agencies, they can act against that agency.
Right. The agency can act against it, must be a law, right?
Yeah.
Page number 7 of your case study.
Yeah, we have seen it, but I forgot the name.
Okay. You talked about some encryption scripts.
Yes.
Can I have a slide? It's written encryption scripts. What exactly are encryption scripts? She covered this part.
Technical and all that, the four members on that one.
So, this one?
Encryption scripts. You covered that?
Yeah, I covered.
Go ahead.
Yeah, because data packets were propagated through the network using some encryption script in order to avoid hacking. And they got that encryption script details. So they use that to hide in the network. See, the data packets were encrypted and sent through the networks, right? So that particular...
But that wasn't the SSL already old by 10 months?
Yes, SSL was already old.
That is the reason they were able to do this through encryption.
And they were not, because they are not able to monitor because of the SSL expiration. And they used the same encryption script in order to transfer the data. So the transferring of data was also, they were not able to monitor. They thought that it is a normal network data.
Okay. Are you sure about that? How do you think that the hackers got access to databases? How would they jump across databases?
Yes, sir, because in one server, the entire username and password was there, and that was not even encrypted. They were easy, able
they
to...
Had a desk. They had a desk server, which was a database server, where they had all the disputes uploaded, right? And on that server, they had the, as per the case study, you're saying that they had the unencrypted username and password for all the databases?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Does the case study say that anywhere?
Yeah.
You sure about that?
Yes.
When did I miss this? I think I've read this four times over by now. Okay. So one question. You've given some recommended measures of how they should have handled it, right, Donna? Business impact. How do you think, if you were in their, you were their CIO, right? How would you handle this? This is slow. It happened in the month of May. How would you handle it? This is all three of you, but I'd like to hear from.
Business flow, this thing occurs like a breach happens. I will inform all the departments.
Who is all the departments?
IT departments mainly. Because in this case, first the breach.
You are the CIO, the IT department is under you, the IT department.
Yeah, so I will just inform all the things. And
Jump in. First, we have to accept this has been happened, and we have to inform the agencies like IRS, FTC, and all.
Because they are the major main customers of Equifax. IRS,
they are customers
SSA,
also. They are also
and
customers.
The USPS. They three are using Equifax service for identification purpose. So we should be updating them regarding this. Also, around 2 lakh credit card information was stolen in this breach. So that means the hackers can utilize that credit card details for getting the money. So that they should be immediately report regarding this so that they can block the credit cards. But this was not done because almost 1 month gap was.
And they went publicly announcing this thing before informing this IRS and all. That was a failure because like that. And what happened means like then they have to take the technical measures in order to prevent
technology apart. I'm not talking about technology.
Yeah.
Technology is fine. They saw that for 76 days somebody was in their network, residing in their network, and slowly and steadily, under the radar, they picked out all the database. They had about 9,000 database queries, and they slowly picked out all the important information of X amount of people. That 147 or 146 is disputed. How many million were actually affected is disputed. Right? So this happened across how many countries?
Mainly Canada.
Sorry?
US, Canada.
US,
Canada,
and
UK.
Okay, so there were a couple others there as well. But maybe you read that. Sorry?
Mainly just for US
people. Main people, of course, it's a US company. So they were looking at US. So, my point is that from a business perspective, this thing, they've got confirmed on the, around the end of July that something had happened. And when did they go public with it?
September.
September 7. How much of time between?
76.
How much time between appreciating?
1 month, more than 1 month.
More than 1 month. So this is just to make everyone understand, because all of you will face a similar thing. In almost all the cases, this is a similar thing has happened. Now in your case, it involved the month of August, little bit of July, and little bit of September. So maybe about 40 odd days. In those 40 days, they did not go public. They did not tell anyone. You think that would have happened?
Means they might have already reported the IRS, some agencies, their major clients, but as I told, there are almost 2 lakh credit card information stolen.
Okay.
That means they have to be known, right? Those customers need to know that their credit card information is stolen, so they
yes.
can take appropriate actions. But that was not done in this case.
Awesome. Now, why, if something like that didn't happen, then why the hell do you think they paid 700 million?
That because FTC fined them.
What did they fine them for?
For not properly securing the personal information of other people. Because that is against.
So can you jump on that 700 million slide? Whom have they given that money to?
FTC.
Plus other agencies.
Other states.
State actor.
Show me. Where is it written? It was given to consumer agencies and states. Not given just to FTC.
Yeah.
So they gave about 700 million people for all the lawsuits that were filed against them.
No, actually, it's still going on. Anybody can still claim regarding $125 for
that. This company is
going
to go bankrupt.
Yeah.
Website for
that claiming now also.
Yeah,
still
they have
the
whole portal made. Yeah. Everything is there. That's a different issue altogether. My point is, why do you think this 700 million? And that's what is important from their question. How is cyber insurance important here? Is it just about, were they cyber insured? You gave a recommendation that they expect the higher cyber insurance premium. Were they cyber insured for a hack like this, Equifax?
No, previously they were.
How do you know?
And
is it written in the case study?
No, not like in the link blogs we have read. But
okay.
Because they don't.
So
have
if they were cyber insured, why do you think they'll have a problem? Insurance will pay for it.
But still, there is a lot of reputation.
That's fine. But you're recommending higher cyber insurance premium, and they're giving 700 million. So if they're given 700 million, why should they be worried? Because there is insurance.
But the next insurance will be insurance premium will be high, right? That's how insurance works.
Fair enough. But they still have insurance.
Yes.
So how is insurance? Yeah, the most critical part of your whole case study is insurance. This case study hinges on not the technological thing. Technological thing is something that you finish off in about 3 pages in the case study, and that's the end of it. This is a 40-page case study, right? It talks about the law. It talks about cyber insurance as an instrument. That's the focus of this case study. So how do you think cyber insurance is affected? This is just a question for a debate. I'm not judging you.
If there was no cyber insurance, means as you said, the company would have gone bankrupt.
Yeah.
Right now they are still sustaining because of the cyber insurance they have. Because 700 million is a huge amount, and still they have to give more. It's still not finished well.
How did we come upon? Okay, that's good. Well answered. How do you think they came up with the figure of 147 million?
Because the first they have identified like 143 million only.
Where have they identified that?
Means when the beach, they announced the beach.
Okay. So where is it 147 million people?
Yes.
People. Yeah. So you think that 147 million people in their database, and they're assuming that everything was exposed.
Yes.
So where is that 2 million thing coming?
Means first they thought that one query had not taken any data, and after 1 month only they have identified that query also took the data, and that is about 2.5 million. That comes around 145.5 million.
Okay.
Then again after that they identified that again one year, I think 2018, they identified that another 2.4 million of the data has been lost.
But they are not but sure the last 2.4 is already included in the previous databases.
Right, if they have the list, they get to know.
It's, that's how it's
but they are not confirmed like that.
So how many security agencies did they involve for audit?
Mandiant was their consultant actually.
Mandiant was not an audit company, it was a consultant company. They were providing them IT consultation. They were the third party vendors. Did they involve anyone else?
Then IRS is already.
Means, Homeland Security offered them assistance,
yeah,
but they denied that.
Okay.
Other than that,
IRS has conducted the cyber audit.
IRS has conducted the cyber audit post the breach. Mandarin was providing them IT and cyber security related consultation services. They were managing them.
Yeah.
Mandarin is a big company, by the way. If you are aware of what Mandarin will figure in a couple of other case studies here as well. They manage the world level organizations. So hackers not identified till date?
No.
Sure.
And the data, the mysteries, nobody knows where the data has gone. Usually when a credit card data is stolen, means I write this in a blog, they will immediately sell that in dark web.
Okay.
Then only they can utilize this credit information and steal the money. However, the other ethical hackers who are searching the dark web know this database was formed. So there is some rumors that maybe this is a hack done by remote foreign government for spying on people, some kind of.
Or Chinese.
Someone
said
Chinese government is
there. But anyway,
we have
no
confirmation. US always
says
China, North Korea, Iran, some places. Makes sense.
Yeah,
you can't really prove.
Rumors are going on.
Sorry?
Rumors are going on.
Rumors, that's good. That's for keeping us busy. Okay. How did the United States Postal Service get involved?
Means they are one of the customers of Equifax. They use identity verification for delivery of parcels.
Excellent, good work. Alright, so I have been asking people questions, you can switch off the camera.